فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، واشهد ان لا اله الا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، واشهد ان سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى اله واصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد، وإن كتاب دفع إيهام للضراب، دفع إيهام للضراب عن آيات الكتاب written by الشيخ العلامة محمد الأمين بن محمد المختار بن عبد القادر الجكني الشنقيطي رحمه الله تعالى. We are on the sixth verse. The Sheikh رحمه الله says قوله تعالى the statement of Allah. مثلهم كمثل الذي استوقد نارا. The Sheikh says أفرد في هذه الآية الضمير في قوله استوقد وفي ما حوله، وجمع الضمير في قوله ذهب الله بنورهم وتركهم في ظلمات لا يبصرون، مع أن مرجع كل هذه الضمائر شيء واحد، وهو لفظة الذي من قوله مثلهم كمثل الذي. The Sheikh رحمه الله, he brings the 17th verse of Surah Al-Baqarah, and now he wants to, inshallah ta'ala, uplift an apparent contradiction that may occur to some people's minds. Now this one, with all honesty, does not seem like a contradiction in any way, form or shape. But the Shaykh rahimahullah ta'ala, his way of dealing in this book, as I said to you, is that he does not mind, he does not care the level of concern regarding a verse. Because the issue of seeing a verse contradictive is a subjective matter. It differs from person to person. Some people may not see this as a contradiction, whereas some others may. So the Shaykh's job, rahimahullah, was, and the way he dealt with this was that he made sure that every verse that may have any form of concern regarding it, or even a question mark to it, by anyone, he wants to answer it for them. Alayhi rahmatullah. But as I said, this verse does not seem to have any flaws or any contradiction regarding it. But as nowhere in the Quran does. But the issue is, some verses, the concern and the worry might be a bit high for some people, or a lot of people. But this one seems like it's not going to be for a lot of people. The Sheikh's concern, or the he wants to bring out, that may occur to some people, is that the ayah says, مَثَلْهُمْ كَمَثَلِ الَّذِي اسْتَوْقَدَ. He says, أَفْرَدَ فِي هَذِهِ الْآيَةِ الضَّمِيرَ. The pronoun in this verse, which is الَّذِي, in which Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala uses استوقد نارا. Allah says ما حوله. حوله, the ha in there, حوله, is a pronoun that's singular. Are you with me? So أفرد في هذه الآية الضمير في قوله استوقد نارا. So وفي ما حوله, behind حوله, the pronoun in there, the ha is singular. Okay. وجمع الضمير في قوله, and then look, it's plural in what? ذهب الله بنورهم. بنورهم, him is a pronoun, is plural. وتركهم, هم is another plural. في ظلمات لا يبصرون. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is speaking about the same people, one time referring to them in a singular and one time referring to them in a plural. Even that though, all of these pronouns are going back to what? Alladhi. The one that says, ma hawlahu. If you, the marja of that dhamir, the returning of that dhamir, what that hat goes back to is alladhi. Binurihim wa tarakahum, both go back to what? Alladhi as well. مع أن مرجع كل هذه الضمائر شيء واحد وهو لفظة الذي. They all go back to the wording الذي, which is in what? مثلهم كمثل الذي. So look we have here, look we have ما حوله I think the ha is going back to who? Alladhi. That pronoun goes back to Alladhi. ذهب الله بنورهم وتركهم is going back to what? Alladhi. So how does that work? والجواب عن هذا, the answer to this is أن لفظة الذي مفرد. So the Sheikh now is going to give us three answers. Sheikh Muhammad Amin al-Shaqita rahimahullah is going to give us three answers of how to answer it. Two answers are strong according to him, and the third opinion is very weak. He weakens it. He weakens the third opinion. The first one is أن لفظة الذي مفرد, that the word الذي is singular wording. ومعناه عام, but the meaning in it is plural. لكل ما تشمله صلتها, based on everything in which it's connected to. In other words, the الذي is a صلة, and it has موصول, it's موصول, sorry, and is صلة connecting to something that is connected to. And this is something we took, remember when we were talking about Al-Fadh al-Umum. Did we not say Al-Ladhi is from Al-Fadh al-Umum? Siyagh al-Umum. When we took Siyagh al-Umum, we said Man. Sah? Man. Istifham. Whether it's Istifham and etc. We said, yeah? Ma. Al-Ladhi. All of those in Usul al-Fiqh, they are dealt with as Siyagh al-Umum. And that's what the Sheikh says, وَقَدْ تَقَرَّرَ فِي عِلْمِ الْأُصُولِ أَنَّ الْأَسْمَاءَ الْمَوْصُولَةَ كُلُّهَا مِنْ سِيَغِ الْعُمُومِ. They are from what? They are from the general wordings, generalization they show. عموم. صحيح? And we did that before when we spoke about, it's in the specific book. When we were speaking about the عموم, we said the عموم were what? مَنْ. Whether it's a mawsoola, is it shartiya or istifhamiya? We said ma, if it's a mawsoola, isim mawsoola, al-istighraqiyya, kul, al-mufrad al-mudaf, al-nakira fi siyaqi al-nahi, aw al-istifhami, aw al-sharti. Ha, we spoke about that. Isn't that the case? So al-ladhi is min isim mawsool, and it's from min siyaqi al-umum. So, but we have to take an exception out of here. Generally speaking, the ism mawsool, it shows what? Umum. إلا ما دل الدليل على أنه لم يرد منها العموم. Except anything that the evidence shows that it's not intended, it is not intended to show generalization, such as قوله تعالى, Allah's statement, والتي أحسنت فرجها. This is not meant by every person. والتي is اسم موصول, but it's not meant by every woman. It's only meant by who? Specifically, Isa ibn Maryam's mom. Maryam bint Imran is the one that's intended here. The only person who's intended here is Isa ibn Maryam's mother, Maryamah, who والتي أحسنت, even though the والتي is used here. This والتي is not عموم. It's only specifically to her. And the evidence is shown that it's specifically to her. But generally speaking, نعم, that the أسماء الموصولة is from سياغ العموم. We took that. فإذا تحققت ذلك, so if that is the case, فعلم نو أن إفراد الضمير باعتبار لفظة الذي وجمعه باعتبار معناه. So what, now somebody is going to ask you and say to you, ما حوله, what, is that plural or is that singular? ما حوله is a singular, and it's going back to what? Alladhi. That is looking at alladhi as a letter, the wording. So that ma hawlahu is going back to the wording. Whereas dhahaballahu binurihim wa tarakahum, when it's plural, is not going back to the wording, it's going back to the meaning. It's going back to the meaning. So when the singular was used, it was going back to the wording, which is alladhi is a singular word. Sahih? But ذهب الله بنورهم وتركهم is going back to the meaning, not the wording. So that's what the Sheikh says. There's two اعتبار observing it. اعتبار لفظه and there's اعتبار of its معنى, its meaning. And he goes, وَلِهَذَا الْمَعْنَى جَرَى عَلَى أَلْسِنَةِ الْعُلَمَاءِ أَنَّ الَّذِي تَأْتِي بِمَعْنَى الَّذِينَ. And now the second view, opinion, Sheikh mentions, which is what? The second opinion, which is what? That the الَّذِي in the verse is actually الَّذِينَ. لَفْضًا وَمَعْنًا. So it should be كَمَثَلِ الَّذِي اسْتَوْقَدَ أي كَمَثَلِ الَّذِينَ اسْتَوْقَدُوا. That's what it is. لَفْضًا وَمَعْنًا. That's what the Shaykh, that's the second opinion. ذَهَبَ اللَّهُ بِنُورِهِمْ. So it's correct. There's no problem with that one. So he brings shawahid from ayat to support this opinion. He says, كَقَوْلِهِ تَعَالَى وَكَقَوْلُهُ, like Allah's statement, وَالَّذِينَ جَاءُوا بِالصِّدْقِ وَصَدَّقَ بِهِ أُولَئِكَ. The beginning is وَالَّذِينَ. Sorry, وَالَّذِي, sorry, which is a singular. But then Allah says, أُولَئِكَ. So that shows it's plural. It's meant to be, the verse is meant to be, وَالَّذِينَ جَاءُوا بِالصِّدْقِ وَصَدَّقَ بِهِ أُولَئِكَ هُمُ الْمُتَّقُونَ. So that's another one. And also the statement of Allah, لَا تُبْطِلُوا صَدَقَاتِكُمْ بِالْمَنِّ وَالْأَذَى كَالَّذِي يُنْفِقُ مَالَهُ رِئَاءَ النَّاسِ. What does the beginning say? لَا تُبْطِلُوا صَدَقَاتِكُمْ بِالْمَنِّ وَالْأَذَى كَالَّذِي, singular, right? After that, what does Allah say? لَا يَقْدِرُونَ عَلَى شَيْءٍ. لَا يَقْدِرُونَ, it's plural. So الَّذِي is going back to لَا يَقْدِرُونَ, which is, in other words, is meant to be كَالَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ. Instead of الَّذِي يُنْفِقُ, is like كَالَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ. So here the الَّذِي is actually الَّذِينَ. لَفْضًا وَمَعْنًا. وَقَوْلُهُ, and statement of Allah, وَخُذْتُمْ كَالَّذِي خَاضُوا. وَخُذْتُمْ كَالَّذِي خَاضُوا. In other words, it's meant to be وَخُذْتُمْ كَالَّذِينَ خَاضُوا. That's what the Shaykh is saying. بِنَاءً عَلَى الصَّحِيحِ مِنْ أَنَّ الَّذِي فِيهَا مَوْصُولَةُ لَا مَزْدَرِيَةَ. There's a khilaf amongst the scholars. وَخُذْتُمْ كَالَّذِي خَاضُوا. The الَّذِي there, is it الَّذِي which is a mawsula, or is it الَّذِي which is a mazdariyah? So if it's a mawsula, as I said, it's going to be وَخُذْتُمْ أَنْ كَالَّذِينَ خَاضُوا. That's the opinion that Sheikh's going to take. But if it's mazdariyah, it's going to be وَخُذْتُمْ كَخَوْضِكُمْ. نعم. And now that he's brought verses from the Quran, he's going to bring verses from the kalam of the Arabs, that they use it like that. He said, كَقَوْلُ الرَّاجِزِ, like the statement of the poet who said, يَا رَبِّ عَبْسٍ لَا تُبَارِكْ فِي أَحَدٍ فِي قَائِمٍ مِّنْهُمْ وَلَا فِي مَنْ قَعَدْ إِلَّا الَّذِي قَامُوا بِأَطْلَافِ الْمَسَدْ. إِلَّا الَّذِي, the الَّذِي here is what? الَّذِي here is singular. The الَّذِي is here singular. قَامُوا is a what? Is a jama. So the silatuhu, the sila of الَّذِي is قَامُوا, which is that wawul jama. So in other words, meant to be الَّذِينَ قَامُوا. So الَّذِي here. وَقَوْلُ الشَّاعِرِ, and the statement of the poet. And who, this poet is who? أَشْهَبِ بْنُ رُمَيْلَةِ وَأَنْشَدَهُ سِيبَوَيْهِ. And also Sibawayhi used it, لإطلاق الَّذِي وإرادتِ الَّذِينَ. That the word الَّذِي is used and الَّذِينَ is intended. Such as, وَإِنَّ الَّذِي حَانَتْ بِفَلْجٍ دِمَاؤُهُمْ هُمُ الْقَوْمُ كُلُّ الْقَوْمِ يَا أُمُّ خَالِدٍ. Again here we find what? الَّذِي is used, and then بِفَلْجِ دِمَاؤُهُمْ, their blood. You see, هُمُ الْقَوْمُ, قَوْم is plural. قَوْم is plural. وزعم ابن الأنباري, ابن الأنباري claimed, his name is called أبو بكر ابن محمد ابن الأنباري. He's a نحوي اللغوي, he's a scholar of the Arabic language, and he died the year 328. If you look at the كتاب بغية الوعاظ, بغية الوعات, written by الإمام السيبوي رحمه الله, السيوطي رحمه الله, sorry, he speaks about him over there. Even تهذيب written by Tahdhib al-Azhari, Tahdhib al-Lugha by al-Azhari, you'll find him, he quotes him and brings him as a lot, رحمه الله تعالى. وزعم ابن الأنباري أن لفظة الذي في بيت أشهب جمع اللذ بالسكون وأن الذي في الآية مفرد ها أريد بها الجمع. So the statement of Anbari here is that the word, the line of poetry which we read, which is Ashhab ibn Rumayla's statement, which is إِنَّ الَّذِي حَانَتْ بِفَلْجٍ دِمَاؤُهُمْ هُمُ الْقَوْمُ كُلُّ الْقَوْمِ يَأُمُّ خَالِدٍ. The الَّذِي that's been used here is actually الَّذِي, which with the sukun. And that the alladhi that's in the verse is a mufradun intended by a jama'. But the great scholar of the Arabic language, Imam Sibawayhi rahimahullah, he doesn't accept that from Ambari and rejected it. And Imam Sibawayhi didn't accept it. And that's why Muhammad al-Amin al-Shanqiyati said, وَأَنْشَدَهُ Sibawayhi. He wants to mention that this is something Sibawayhi strengthens as well. This understanding of this line of poetry of Ash'ab ibn Rumaylah. The third opinion, which is the last one, is وَقَوْلُ عُدَيْلِ بْنُ الْفَرْجِ عُدَيْلِ بْنُ فَرْخِ الْعِجْلِ. Some people say عَدِيل, some say عُدَيْل. I've seen all of that. وَبِتُ أُسَاقِ الْقَوْمَ وَبِتُ أُسَاقِ الْقَوْمَ إِخْوَةِ الَّذِي غَوَايَتُهُمْ غَيِّي وَرُشْتُهُمْ رُشْتِي. So he brings that line to poetry just to prove the previous point. But the last one is وَقَالَ بَعْضُهُمْ. This is the third opinion. وَقَالَ بَعْضُهُمْ. And some of them claimed الْمُسْتَوْقِدُ وَاحِدُ لِجَمَاعَةٍ مَعَهُ. That the مُسْتَوْقِد, the one who is finding the fire, is actually one, but he's doing it for a group of people. So in other, so the ayah can be clear. He's saying that it's only one person who wants to. مَثَلُ الَّذِي كَمَثَلِ الَّذِي اسْتَوْقَدَ نَارًا. Is one person, but he's doing it for a lot of people. So when the jama' is being used, it's talking about the people who he's doing it for, and when the singular is being used, it's referring to him alone. But that qawl, Shaykh Muhammad ibn al-Shanqiyati says, وَلَا يَخْفَى ضَعْفُهُ. The weakness of that is not hidden from anyone. Meaning it's weak, very weak opinion. So I have three answers in summary. خُلَاصَةُ الْقَوْلِ is that we have three answers. The first view is that الَّذِي is مُفْرَدٌ in its wording, أن لفظة الذي مفرد ومعناه عام, and the meaning is general. The second one is no. كمثل الذي is actually الذين لفظا ومعنا. لفظا ومعنا. And he brought many ayat for that, such as قوله تعالى والذين جاءوا بالصدق وصدق به أولئك هم المتقون. And قوله تعالى لا تبطلوا صدقاتكم بالمن والأذى كالذي ينفق ماله رئاء الناس. And the evidence for showing you that الَّذِي هِيَ is لَا يَقْدِرُونَ عَلَى شَيْءٍ مِّمَّا كَسَبُوا is the same ayah, same verse, لَا يَقْدِرُونَ. So it's meant to be كَالَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ. That's what Shaykh said. وَخُذْتُمْ كَالَّذِي خَاضُوا أي كَالَّذِينَ خَاضُوا. If we take your opinion, of course, that the الَّذِي هِيَ is what? مَوْصُولَةٌ لَا مَزْدَرِيَةٌ. And he brought some examples from the kalam of the Arab, the قول of the Rajis, who said, يا ربي عبسي لا تبارك في أحد في قائم منهم ولا في من قعد إلا الذين إلا الذي قاموا بأطراف المسد. It's meant to be إلا الذين قاموا. And also the other line of poetry. And the third opinion that he brought to the table was what? That the mustawqid is one person, but he's doing it for a lot of people. So when you see the singular is referring to the mustawqid, and when you see the jama'ah, the plural that's being used in the pronoun, is basically referring to the people who he's going to fire for. وَلَا يَخْفَى ضَعْفُهُ. And the Shaykh weakened the third of the opinions. We'll stop there inshaAllah ta'ala for today's session with دَفْعِ هَامِلُ الضِّرَابِ عَنْ آيَاتِ الْكِتَابِ. Anything I have said that was wrong, فَإِنَّهُ مِنِّي وَمِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ وَاللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ بَرِئَانِ مِنْهُ. سُبْحَانَكَ اللَّهُمَّ بِحَمْدِكَ أَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ أَسْتَغْفِرُكَ وَأَتُوبُ إِلَيْهِ.